two local scientists are up for a national STEM award for their research into technology that could mitigate the effects of climate change. Those scientists are also happen to be 12 and 14 years old. The award is through the Thermo Fisher Junior Investors Challenge, which brings middle schoolers from across the country to show their research, collaboration, and critical thinking skills. Representing Massachusetts, sixth grader Johan Koisman from Weston tested artificial clouds that could cool down the earth. And seventh grader Stephen Cronin from Norwood looked at making geoengineered curtain to slow glacial melting. They both join me now in the studio to talk about what they found. Thank you guys so much for coming in. Let's start with you, Johan. Tell me, what do we have here? What's your project and what was the problem that you were working to solve?
So basically, the problem I was trying to solve is that global warming, it's an existential threat to life on planet Earth.
Yeah.
And the thing I have right here is the cloud chamber. At the top, there's a heat lamp that acts as a sun.
Mm-hmm.
And then in the middle, there's a ceramic non-heat conducting bowl with an atomizer in it that produces the cloud.
Okay, so this is a cloud chamber, and the goal is to create clouds that could actually cool the Earth?
Yeah.
Okay, and how does it work? What did you do to make it work and to test that it would work?
What I tested to see if it would work is I tested different types of clouds.
Mm-hmm.
So there would be like a 3-micron cloud, 7-micron cloud, 10-micron cloud, and different types of salinity.
And this is the size of the water particles in the cloud and the salinity of that water. And you could measure the difference in the cooling effect of the cloud?
Uh-huh, because there's a thermometer at the bottom, and we just saw whatever the temperature would be.
What did you find?
Well, the 3-micron and, in our case, which is the highest amount of salinity, the 15%, was the most reflective.
Amazing. All right. And Stephen, can you tell me about your research and what were you looking into? What was the problem that you were trying to solve?
All right. So for my research, I was looking at a geoengineered curtain. So in my research, I'd have the warm water. The geoengineered curtain would...
is a curtain that would go around a glacier, right?
Yes.
And the problem is that the glaciers are melting, right?
Yes, the glaciers are melting, which would contribute to a lot of sea level rise. For example, the Thwaites Glacier contributes to 4% of sea level rise throughout the whole world, so that's pretty a big deal about sea level rise.
Of course. And you wanted to see if we could actually geoengineer a giant curtain to go around a glacier that would prevent warm water from getting to the glacier.
Yes.
Okay. And how does it work?
So I anchor these two ropes to the sides of the aquarium, and then I have fishing weights at the bottom, so it wouldn't go like back and forth; it would just stay straight. And mm-hmm. then I have these fishing bobbers, which would float, so it wouldn't like sink or anything. And then inside my geoengineered curtain, I do have two tubes with sand and one tube with air. Those are all good thermal insulators, so that would protect the warm water from getting to the glacier. So.
Wow. Okay. And then you measured the temperature of the water on either
yes.
side of the curtain, and did you find that it actually prevented warm water from getting to where the glacier would be?
Yes, it did, and my hypothesis was supported in my experiments, all of my tests.
This is a huge project. I mean, the glacier is enormous, right? It's
yes.
the size of Florida, I think you said?
Yes.
Is it even possible to create a barrier like this that would prevent warm water from getting to the glacier?
Well, there are many challenges to do this. There are like... So, like, it's really cold in Antarctica. Also, like, it's really hard to, like, drive a ship to Antarctica, and then it would be hard to build.
Yeah, huge logistical problem. But
yes.
but possible? You're hopeful it could happen?
Yes, I believe
and
it could.
And there are scientists who are actually working on
yes.
making this happen.
Yes, like a lot of glaciologists from Princeton. Like, for example, in British Columbia.
Okay. And your project is also something that people really, scientists are currently working on, and the idea could actually happen, right?
Mm-hmm.
And, I mean, I wanted to ask you both, I mean, you could have focused on any topics, and you both chose climate change, and specifically these massive geoengineering projects to actually get around the problems, you know. Climate change is clearly going to be a huge challenge for even, especially for the youngest people, right? Mm-hmm. Are you finding that this is something that your generation, your classmates, are really focused on? You know, what drew you to this?
Basically, none of my classmates, they've heard of the idea of climate change, but they don't really know too much about it.
Yeah.
And the reason why I thought of this is that actually, I was reading this book, and it really scared me with they said could happen.
Yeah.
Like, and at the end of the century, temperatures could rise by 3 degrees Fahrenheit.
Yeah.
It's like just massive.
It's terrifying.
Yeah.
Are you optimistic? Are you hopeful that projects like this could make a difference? And are you planning on being part of that solution?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. How do you feel? Do you seem that optimistic about the ability of scientists to address this problem, or are we too far gone at this point?
I think we do have the ability to be optimistic about it. I'm optimistic about it because of how successful my science fair project was in. I know a bunch of researchers and glaciologists are thinking about doing my project too.
Yeah, okay. Do you think that the technological advances like what you're talking about is going to be enough, or do we need to do more to actually reduce, you know, the impact we're having on the climate with carbon?
So it's basically happening from the greenhouse gases. So if we could like just limit that by by a few degrees Fahrenheit, then it would be a lot different for us, and that would be a lot better.
Yeah. Is this kind of project fun for you, or is this something that you do because it's something you take so seriously, or do you enjoy this?
I think it's kind of both.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. How about you? Is this a fun
yes,
thing?
Yes, this is definitely a part of both because I'm very interested in science and glaciers and climate change, and also it makes me feel nervous sometimes when I see the effects of climate change around like low-lying areas like New York, Florida, and other low-lying countries.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. I think we should all be scared of what's happening right now, but I think we can all be really optimistic about the work that you guys are doing and that you're taking it so seriously, and hope that there's many more like you who are doing this kind of research. Good luck in the national competition. I hope that you both do really well in it, and thank you guys so much for coming on and talking to us about it.
Thank you.
It's really great.